Have you ever lost an app on the iPad? I know I have. What can you do? How can you find that app? And once you found it, how can you add it back to your home screen? Well, that's what we're going to look at in this video. Let's take a look at how we can find our lost apps on the iPad and add them back to our home screens. Now, before we get started, I first want to mention I am using an iPad Pro, but it's about 3 or 4 years old, so this isn't the latest iPad Pro. But it is using iPadOS 17. But everything that I'm going to show you here works with older iPads, such as this iPad Pro here, and I believe it also will work with older iPadOS versions. This is nothing new with iPadOS 17. Everything I'm going to show you here is nothing new with iPadOS 17. All right, with that out of the way, let's take a look at how we can find our lost apps. Let's go over to my iPad. There are basically two ways to find lost apps. One way is through search. To get to your search, what we need to do is just swipe down from the top. And when we swipe down, we have our search. And now all I need to do is just type in here what I'm looking for. So I'm looking for an app called Tripsy. It is not on any of my home screens, or at least I can't find it. And I'm not going to go through all of my different folders. All I need to do is just start typing it in here, and you're going to see that it finds the app. So now all I need to do is just tap on that and it'll open it up. So that's the first way. That's generally how I will do it, is through search. But also what we can do is we can find it in the app library. If you're familiar with a Mac, you know that we have an applications folder with all of our applications in alphabetical order. Well, we basically have the same thing on the iPad. It's called your app library. This was introduced, I believe, in iPadOS 15. Maybe 16, but at least it's a couple years old. To get to your app library, what we need to do is we just need to swipe to the last home screen. So I have a number of different home screens here. So what I need to do is I need to swipe to the left until I get to the last home screen. So I swipe, 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 and swipe, and now I'm looking at my app library. So we have to get to that last home screen. Now, I mentioned that it is in a list in alphabetical order. This doesn't look like a list. It's a bunch of folders. Well, now what we need to do is we just need to swipe down. And when we swipe down, I get my list of apps. So now what I'm able to do is swipe through here and find the app that I'm looking for. You're also going to see all of the letters here, so I can just tap on the letter like T for Tripsy. So let's go ahead and find it. I just swipe up, and we're going to see, when I swipe up here, there's Tripsy. So now all I need to do is just tap on that and it'll open up. So that's how you can find your lost apps. Now, let's say you wanted to add this to your home screen. I would like to add this to my first home screen. How can we do that? Well, we can use drag and drop. If we're at our app library, so I'm at my app library here, what we need to do is just long press on the icon here. We do not want to long press on the name. What we need to do is long press on the icon itself. And when I do, what I'm able to do is drag this over to my home screen. So I'm just going to swipe until I get to my first home screen, and I place it where I want. And now that app is on my first home screen here. So that's one way. I can also do this through search. So let's go to my second home screen. I'll go to the fourth one here, where I have some blank spaces here. I want to add that app here as well. We can't install an app on more than one home screen. I'm going to use search to do this. So now what I do is I just swipe down to get to my search. And we have Tripsy here. And again, all I have to do is just long press on it, and I drag it where I want. And now I just place it where I want. And now it's installed on my home screen. I can also place it into a folder if you want to put it into a folder. So those are the ways that we can find our apps as well as install them on our home screen. Now, in some cases, what may happen is when you download an app, it doesn't install on your home screen. There is an actual setting for this. By default, it should install on your home screens here. But what you can do is you can set it to, when you download an app from the App Store, it will not install on any one of your home screens. The only place it's going to install it is on your app library here. So if you have your iPad set up that way, if you want to install it on your home screen, you have to use that drag and drop trick. So where is the setting to set where we want our apps downloaded? Well, what we need to do is we need to go to our settings app. So I'm going to swipe over here. And actually, we're just going to go down to my dock here. It's in my dock. And now what I'm going to do is go over to, on the left side here, our home screen and app library. When we're looking at this, you're going to see there's a setting for newly downloaded apps. What do we want it to do when we download an app? We can have it install on our home screen and the app library. Every app is going to be in that app library. You cannot remove an app from the app library unless you remove it from your iPad. Or what you can do is you can just have it install on your app library itself. And you can see that is how my iPad is set here. So when I download an app from the App Store, the only place it's going to go is my app library. And then I have to install it manually. Now, by default, it is going to be set for Add to Home Screen. Now, why would you want to switch it over to that other mode where it only installs in the app library? Well, in my case here, I have a lot of home screens here. And if I wanted to clean this up, maybe I only want to have two or three home screens, I would move these all around. And then I would make sure when I install an app, I would make sure that it only installs in my app library. And then what I'm able to do is just use that drag and drop trick to place it on the home screen that I want. So I can choose where it's going to go. I can choose on what home screen it's going to go instead of the iPad doing that. When the iPad does that, it can place it on a home screen where you don't want it, and then you'll have to swipe or you can't find it. So that is why you may want to have that setting for where newly installed apps are installed in the library itself only, not on your home screen. Now, if you do want to make sure that it installs on your home screens, which it is set by default, all you have to do is just make sure that it is set for this one here. So that's how you can find your lost apps on the iPad. Maybe you place it in a folder or you installed it and you don't know, you have a lot of home screens, you can't find it. All you have to do is just search for it. Just swipe down to get to the search screen, and then from there you can search for it. Also, you can go over to your app library. Just swipe all the way over to the right to your last home screen and then swipe down, and then you'll see all of your apps in a list. It's going to be in alphabetical order. You can go and find that app and then just long press on that icon, either when it's in search or when it's in the app library, and drag it to the home screen you want. So those are some tips on how you can find your lost apps on the iPad.